It's early morning, the sun just came up, and this guy is hard at work. He looks like he hasn't had his coffee yet. Bumblebee. I believe it's a bumblebee. Yep, and it's on a thistle flower. Thistle grows everywhere around here. This is late summer, early fall. And the flowers that are available to these critters right now are kind of slowing down. We have thistle, and then right above it, in the back, this is called goldenrod. The color is impressive, especially when you're looking at it in 3D. There's a lot of insects. You can see a couple of them on here. And when the sun comes out, it's swarming in bees and flies and wasps and all manner of critters. This grows wild around here. And so I don't ever chop it down because that's the last of the food that these pollinators are going to get this season. Must really kind of suck to be an insect and you know your food's running out. I know that's sounds like a bit of a bummer, doesn't it? Look at my little pollinators over there. Look at them go. Eat faster. Faster. My little vegan army. Yes, they are. Well, not looking so tall now, are you? Raised tomato plant versus Iowa winds and storms. Yeah, remember this thing was way up there? Yeah, way the heck up there. Well, it's not up there anymore. You know, there is just so much that bamboo can do. What can bamboo do for you? Well, the bamboo couldn't hold up to all the weight. Normally, the bamboo could take this plant and hold it straight up. Not a problem at all. Rascal, you best be leaving my pumpkins alone. Anyway, it was holding it up just fine. I was pruning out all the branches. Well, the thing is that the tomatoes started showing up. I don't remember what I did. Let's be honest. I think I showed tomatoes on this one. Oh, no. It was the lower Unctin garden. I showed you tomatoes on that. Well, this one up here, oddly enough, is producing more than the one down there. Go figure. What happened was it got so top heavy, it started leaning. And then what I did is I took these strings and I started tying it up here and there to try to hold it up. Well, it was leaning that way. So I pulled it this way and then it was leaning this way. So I pulled it that way. So there was all this tension and then the wind came along and it just gave up. Yeah, it just gave up and went snap. And it snapped here and the plant, luckily, didn't snap. It bent. Isn't it weird? The plant bent, but the poles supporting it, they broke. And then it laid over on top of the asparagus. I thought, okay, don't nobody breathe because my plant hasn't broken. My tomatoes are safe. And I love gardening. I just do because of all the weird stuff that happens when you don't expect it. Okay, plant lays down and it looks really stupid. And I'm glad nobody's looking at my garden. And then it starts growing again. This is all new growth. So the plant that falls down, it has new growth that decides to come back up. It just doesn't know when to stop. Here is the trussed up gigantor mess that was my tomato plant. You can see it up close. And then right over here, yep, there's the broken bamboo. I've been using this bamboo for years. I've grown to really rely on it and love it. I even have steel bars with string that was holding it up, but even that couldn't hold it. And let me show you what caused it to fall over. In here. Yep. These are those. The big fat stinking tomatoes. They grow in clusters. They run in packs. And it keeps going deeper and deeper into there. You can see them way down in there. Everywhere you look, you're going to see these monsters all over the place. This didn't produce tomatoes early in the season, so this is definitely not an early season tomato. It's a late season tomato. When everything else is petering out, this one's just getting going, and it goes all over onto the other side. Yes, I'm going to definitely show off here because I got something worth showing off. Over on this side, you can see even more. And it goes all the way underneath it from the top. dozens of these basketballs are what toppled this plant. So it was a good thing, bad thing. It produced more than I could ever dream of or imagine. And yet the weight of it is what its downfall was. So yeah, not so good. But on the bright side of this, we have, check it out. They're about ready to start opening up. Bolls of cotton. Yes, the critters that were living in my garden, the rats, finally decided to leave. Not of my doing, because I didn't kill them. I don't know, apparently they got their mind right. Remember that rat I told you about that was running around in here? Yeah, they left. And they left me these. So these hopefully will start popping open, and I'm going to have seeds for more cotton. Yeah, that's the craziest thing. Now, one thing I do have to get rid of today, and I don't mean get rid of it by throwing it away, I mean by harvesting, is this pepper plant. I was going to set the camera on a tripod and show you, but you really can't appreciate it unless you're down where I am. So I hope you don't mind being down here. This is that Pusa Jwala, unpruned this season and left to grow wild in the shadow of the tomato. This is what it did. These are all the fruits of its labors, and they go on and on in layers upon layers through this plant from top to bottom. Yeah, and oh yeah, there's still some green ones here, but they're turning red. They are the most vivid red that I've seen in peppers in a long time. I'm gonna pick these and see how many I get. I'm popping these things off as fast as I can, and I brought my little Barbie bucket out with me. I didn't know what size container I was going to need. One thing I also didn't take into consideration is possibly wearing gloves when you pick peppers that might have a Scoville rating so high that you don't ever want to touch yourself again with those hands. Yeah, well, it's a little bit too late now, so I'm just going to go for it. I did mention that I want to taste one of these. I've never tasted one before. And if I tell you I've never tasted one, you can believe it. I'm not one for really hot peppers. I like pickled jalapenos, but that's about as hot as I go. I mentioned that I want to taste one, and that's what I'm going to do. I think I pretty much got all of these off that I'm going to get. And let me just pop one out of here. I want to take one of the smaller ones. I don't want to eat one of the larger ones. Now this, let me show you. This is the harvest so far. This is about half of what the plant has. It still has endless amounts on there that are green. Those are going to ripen up. Now, if I would have picked these earlier while they were green, it would have forced the plant to put out new flowers and put out new peppers. That's the whole idea behind picking your peppers early as opposed to waiting later in the season. The balancing on that is if you pick them early, you get more peppers. If you pick them later, you get all ripe peppers, which tend to have more flavor than the green ones or the yellow ones. Now, this one has no smell. It actually smells like green onions because it's growing right next to the green onions. I'm going to taste this and let you know what I think. And I'm sure the heat is going to kill me. So those of you who like to see Ray in pain, enjoy yourself. Oh. Oh. Pardon me. That's no Thai pepper. But it tastes, it has a flavor like a Thai pepper. I'm sorry for spitting like that. I didn't mean to freak you out. It was getting really hot, really fast, and I was afraid it was going to go way beyond my ability to handle, and you can actually get sick if you eat something that's way too hot for you. I've seen people do that. All right, now, I'm going to give this one to the earth. My lips, my tongue, my throat, it hits a hot really fast, but then it goes down relatively quick. Not super fast, but relatively quick. And I like that because I wouldn't want a hot pepper that just burns me and burns me and then knocks me down on the ground and then burns me some more. If I want a hot pepper, and these are very much like Thai in their heat, okay? Thai peppers for me hit their heat a little bit slower and it lasts and then it tapers off. This one hits it quick, just like that, and it mellows out relatively quick. That's not so bad. This would be good for stir frying, for hot stuff, for Indian food. These are from India, and Indian is known for its spicy, delicious foods. And I can imagine using these, definitely. If I were gonna do hot, spicy dishes like Szechuan and things like that, absolutely I would use these. Now, I don't know what I'm gonna use these for because I don't do a lot of hot cooking. Maybe I'll give them away. I don't really know. So that, my friends, is the story. I'm sorry if I disappointed you by spitting that out, not going nuts and screaming and ranting and raving and doing the hot pepper challenge, but that wasn't my intention. My intention was to just see what the flavor is on this. Now, the flavor is good. It's not a Thai pepper. I think Thai pepper has a different flavor that I like. This one has a good flavor, and I do like it, but it's not a Thai pepper. And that's what the mistake I made is, assuming that just because it looks like a Thai pepper, it's gonna taste like a Thai pepper. So no, these are nothing like Thai peppers, at least not my opinion. So I'm gonna finish picking these and then try to figure out what to do with them. I don't know, maybe I'll dry them or something like that and have Mike take, oh, I know, yeah. I could see if Mike wants to take these into Walmart and give them to the guys and girls that work at Walmart, the employees there. They would appreciate that. You know, they don't sell these kind of peppers in Walmart, at least not in our Walmart they don't. I'm sure in some Walmarts they do, not in ours. They have jalapenos, habaneros at times, and they don't look that good because they've been sitting there a long time. Now these, I think they would appreciate. So I want to make sure that if I'm growing something, somebody somewhere is going to appreciate it. And if I'm not going to eat these, I want somebody else to appreciate them. So there we go. Half of the harvest of the Pusa Jwala. For the seeds, a viewer sent me these seeds. I want to thank you. It was a pleasure growing this, and it's got a lot more to give out, and it's a beautiful plant. I got a feeling I would have gotten a humongous plant had I grown this out in full sun, not next to a tomato plant. This plant is definitely a grower, and I would highly recommend it for any of you who want little hot peppers that have a good flavor. Definitely. Yep, this is my choice of pepper for that. Now, I didn't bring you here just for peppers. I'm gonna probably try and get some onions out of here if I can get this little badger out of my onion patch. Yeah, well, that's what happens when you have a dog looking for mice. And he doesn't hurt the onions, but he does step all over them. Hey, it's what he does. It didn't hurt him at all. Now these green onions, generally, look at how close I am. Generally these green onions are harvested a lot sooner than this, but they were grown in the shade of the asparagus and the tomatoes and the peppers, so I don't fault them for that. They did the best that they possibly can. And green onions will grow all season long. I planted them way, way too close. I've been asked, Ray, how do you plant your green onions? How do you space them? And my answer is to at first laugh and then put on a serious face and tell the person that I just plant them, I sprinkle them in, and then as they grow, I harvest them up like this. And when I do harvest them, this is what they look like. I believe these are called Tokyo green onions. Yep. And all I do is pop them off, and I can use all of this green. Every part of this onion is edible at any stage that you're growing it. Now, what I like to do is, I don't like this outer part. This outer skin tends to be a little bit chewy. So I pop that off, and then I'm gonna cut the roots off in the house. But out here, I pop off about maybe this much, because this part is still tender enough and flavorful enough for me. This I just don't need. So I throw this back into the garden. I lay it in the garden and let the soil take it back. I give back to the garden. Now this part is very tender and very smooth. This part is not quite as tender, but it does have flavor. The greener it gets, the more flavor it's going to have. So this is my green onion. This is how I picked them. And you can harvest these generally all summer long. And I found out from last year, if you don't pick them all out, or if you just cut them off at ground level, they're going to grow back, and they'll probably grow back next spring. Yes, I had green onions popping up here early this spring. So yeah, they are definitely a plant that keeps on producing, and you definitely get your money's worth out of these. You know, nothing in my life comes close to the feeling I get when I pull things out of the ground that I've grown and it turns out right. It's a beautiful feeling. You know what I'm talking about. You do. Those of you who garden, you may have had a lot of mistakes and a lot of mess ups, but you've had a success or two, just like I have. And you know that feeling. And that's the addiction that starts setting in, that keeps us going, that keeps us growing the next year and the next year and the next year. This tomato, I'm going to talk about in just a moment. But the green onions are a simple thing to grow. For those of you who can't grow regular onions, you know, bulb onions, regardless of why, green onions are a great thing to grow because they smell good, they produce faster, they're delicious. They go in all different kinds of foods. I'm going to be picking a whole bunch of them today. I just picked a few for right now. But the peppers, these are, like I mentioned, they're delicious, actually. Now that the heat's worn off, I taste the flavor and I like these. Now, if I could handle hotter peppers, I would grow these all the time because they're prolific. Why not? Now, for those of you who want a hot pepper, I would definitely say yes, go for those. Now, what's in this mystery can? This is my wallow beans. These are green beans. These are Kentucky Wonder pole beans. These are not the bush beans. Now, I've been picking these things. I can't eat anymore. Don't tell me to eat another bean. I just can't do it. I won't do it. You can't make me. I picked them. I processed them. I froze them. I ate them. I'm ready for the winter. I got plenty of beans. And this is still filled with green, yellow, brown pods. And they're all ready to go. And in here, we have what I'm saving for next year. And what that is dried beans. Yep, this is what you get from the pods when you let them dry and then you harvest the beans. They look like just regular, like pinto beans or northern beans, but no, this is a coffee can, so they're all covered in a little bit of coffee because you know me, I have coffee cans. These I'm saving, and with the vine, I should be able to get a half a can of beans. I just like touching them. They're smooth, cool, hard. It reminds me of pinto beans. Makes me feel good. Yes, it does. Now, Ray, why are you saving so many beans? You're not going to be planting that many beans next year. No, I'm not. You know, here, I only planted 12. Yeah, that's it. 12 beans gave me all of this. Seeds give you so much in return for so little. What I'm saving these for, I'll mention it again, why not? I'm saving these up, and I'm also going to be saving other seeds from other things, like wild things, like the velvet leaf plant, I showed you that, and wild cucumbers that go around here, sunchoke seeds, if I can get any of those. I'm going to be making seed bombs, yes. I'm taking some of my compost that I'm drying out, I'm going to save a little bit off to the side. And then when spring comes along, I'm going to mix it with a little bit of peat moss and these seeds, moisten it, make these little balls, and right before a rainstorm, I'm going to toss them all over there so that the rain will hit them, saturate the compost and stuff, and help them germinate and grow into the ground. And it's going to take over that crappy area that my neighbor has decided to bestow upon me. So he gives me junk. I'm going to give him food. Yes, I am. If he wants to pick these beans and eat them, he's more than welcome to. That's what I'm doing with that. Now, the last thing I want to mention is this. This is one of the tomatoes that's on the vine. That's a decent-sized tomato. No matter how you look at it, that's something you could be proud of when you harvest this tomato. I thought they were Boxcar Willie. Well, Ray thought wrong. Sort of wrong. Now, after reviewing this and researching it and a letter from a friend, I got the information that I got is as follows. I'll break it down to you very simply. This is not Boxcar Willie. No. This is called Mule Team. Okay, this is an old variety just as Boxcar Willie is. And it was developed ages and ages ago by the same person who developed Boxcar Willie. So yes, it's the brother of Boxcar Willie, the bigger brother of Boxcar Willie. It has the flavor that I confused with Boxcar Willie, and that makes sense now. It has that Boxcar Willie rich, slightly tangy, a little bit sweet, but not sweet enough to make you go, ooh, it's sweet, because I don't like sweet tomatoes. This has the acid, this has the flavor. It doesn't have all of that gel inside of it. It has meat, you know, the flesh of the tomato that has juice in the flesh of the tomato. That's unique with tomatoes nowadays. This is a tomato that I cannot say enough good things about. Now, it does grow big. You can see this is an average-sized tomato. This is no honker or no price-setting tomato, but this is a big tomato. And it produces a lot of these gargantuan tomatoes. You got to be ready for that, okay? It doesn't produce early in the season. It produces mid-season all the way up until frost. It's an indeterminate, which means the plant will grow and grow and grow. Nice thing about it, it's a hardy plant, vigorous plant, productive, prolific. The fruit is just the most delicious you've ever had in your life. If you like good old-fashioned tomatoes, the way that they used to be back in ye olden days, this is the one. This is definitely the one. And I'm so impressed with it, I'm not even looking for the regular Boxcar Willies anymore. This is it for me. It's called Mule Team, and I appreciate the seeds that I got and that I planted for this. This is my absolute new favorite. I'm going to grow it different next year. I got a surprise for you, something that's never been done. I've never seen it done on anybody else's programs. I've never even thought of doing it. I was going to sleep one night, and I was thinking tomatoes because, you know, that's what I do. I lay in bed at night, and right before I fall asleep and say, today is a good day, I think about my garden. It helps me unwind from the day, like I really do get wound up, but it does. It helps me unwind a little bit, and I thought about it, and it came to me. I'm going to grow tomatoes a whole different way than I've ever done before. You're going to have to tune in. I'm not giving you any kind of sneak peek into it, but you're going to have to tune in next year, and you're going to watch me do this. I'm going to be building this little contraption that anybody can make. I'm going to be growing it the way that anybody can grow it, and I'm going to see just how much a tomato plant can do when you give it what it absolutely needs. No cutting back. We're going full stop tomato plant next year to see what this Mule Team can do. That's what I'm going to be doing. That's what I have for you today, folks. A little bit of a harvest, taste test, scare in my mouth, and a revelation about tomatoes. If you have any questions, post it in the comment section below. I'm always here for you. If you have any gardening questions whatsoever, let me know. I will do the best I possibly can to give you the best answer I possibly can. Yes, the sun is in my eyes, but you know what? I don't care. So I will see you next week here in the garden. Thanks, everybody, for joining me. I appreciate it. Have a great week. Mule Team. Don't forget the name. Mule Team. And I love a good onion. I do. I really do.